And let's now take you to Parliament, which resumed its sitting today after a two-month recess. And consideration of crucial bills that will pave way for the implementation of the proposed constitutional changes under the Building Bridges Initiative are expected to dominate the first leg of the fifth session of the bicameral Parliament. The Majority Leader in the National Assembly, Amos Kimunya, says he has over 100 pieces of legislation that need to be finalized, but he's resigned to the fate that politics and COVID-19 may highly affect the completion of the task ahead. Chemutai Goin has more on that report.
As the August House resumed for its fifth session, a full intro awaits the 347 legislators. Majority Leader Amos Kimunya, however, acknowledges that managing the MPs may not be a walk in the park owing to the sharp divisions over the BBI bill.
Let your blessings descend upon us here assembled.
And the emerging formations ahead of the next general election, barely a year and a half away.
It's a full intro. Unfortunately, we don't have the time. We also have two limitations because of COVID, so we may not meet as much as we need. The committees will not, meet as much as they need to process all the bills through the committees. So we'll be racing against time. We also know that this is 2021. Next year is election time. So concentration in the House is likely to be reduced.
Kimunya, who replaced Aden Duale, who was unceremoniously ousted as majority leader, is heading a highly divided house, the divisions bound to widen in the coming days, and in what is likely to put President Kenyatta on a collision course with his deputy, is the declaration by the Tanga Tanga allied MPs that they will prioritize hustler-friendly legislations.
On the agriculture bills that they were talking of, it's already part of my priority anyway. In terms of other hustler-friendly bills, I'm not quite sure which are these, but the most hustler-friendly bill that I know is the BBI. If you look at it, if you look in the details of it, you'll see it's all about uniting Kenyans, which is what they were talking about. It's about shifting the politics from tribal-based politics to ideological-based politics.
Kimunya says despite BBI being unpalatable for a cross-section of the population, it could have the antidote for reviving the country's bleak future.
A stable nation, a peaceful nation, is the biggest magnet you have for private investors looking for where to put their money. And there's lots of money floating around the world, but looking for a home where there's stability, predictability, peace, and especially around the election time.
Among the priority legislations are the referendum bills, the renationalization of the National Carrier Kenya Airways, and those relating to boosting the success of the Big Four agenda, which has been slowed down by the prevailing political situation, coupled with the COVID-19 pandemic.
Universal health care is one of the Big Four agenda, and there's a whole raft of health laws amendments. The business laws amendments, which to ease the cost of doing business and to facilitate more investments, which is part of the Big Four agenda again. Then there's lots of bills within the agricultural sector, which again facilitate the food production, which is part of the Big Four agenda.
Also top on the list is the consideration and approval of the 2021-2022 budget policy statement, expected by mid-February to pave way for the commencement of the budget process in June, and also the revenue bills. With a significant drop in labor productivity, export commodities and tourism due to COVID-19, the government is grappling with a shortfall in revenue collection and will need to borrow more to fund government initiatives, noting that this is a legacy year for President Uhuru Kenyatta.
We have stretched our borrowing capacity to almost the end, right? Yet we still need infrastructure projects. So is there a better way of doing it? Yes, let's review our PPP. They have a public-private partnership framework to make it easier for people to bring in their money and invest. Like what's happening now on the Uhuru Highway, what will happen on the Nairobi Summit.
What the House may also get to deal with if it comes to pass is a threat by a section of members of Parliament to table a motion of no confidence in Deputy President William Ruto. Chemutai Goin, Citizen TV, Nairobi.